Hi, it's Murray with the Good Ale Miller team here with an end of April market update on the Oakville real estate market. Results are in, trends are interesting. I just wanted to give you an update. We're hearing in the media that there's doom and gloom in the real estate market, everything's off 60, 70%, which we are, by the way. And I thought I'd share with you a couple of bright spots in the market that might indicate that things are not as bad as they might otherwise seem to be. So here's a quick spreadsheet on the health of the market here in Oakville. You can see in yellow there's 607 listings at the end of the month, which is down from 761 a year ago, April. That's a decline of about 20% in inventory, which is helping us to keep prices in line, etc. In April, in terms of sales, we had 129 sales this year versus 383 last year. So significant difference. That's what we're hearing in the media. Last year at this time, we were selling 50% of the listings that were available at the end of the month. This year it's 21%, so off significantly. A couple things I want to point out and that are interesting as you start looking at segments of the market, as you look at neighborhoods, as you look at the type of property, condo versus non-condo, etc. There are some explanations what's going on, and there's some actually bright spots in the market. And I'd like to share a couple with you today. In blue, you're going to see the under $1 million market. So I've just segmented the market here as of the end of the month. There's 165 listings under $1 million, 174 between $1 million and $1.5 million, et cetera, et cetera, here. So you'll see the distribution of listings. And what I've done here is I've shown the sales in the first part of the month, the second part of the month, so the second 2 weeks, and what's conditionally sold at the end of the month. And these are particularly of interest because they firm up and show up when they firm up in the month in which they were sold. So all of these were conditionally sold as of April 30th. So if and when they all firm up, and that's a big if, they don't all firm up, but let's say, you know, 85 or 90% of them do. And for the purposes of this discussion, I'm going to say they're all going to firm up. We've got 31 at the end of the month that are actually going to show up in this category right here. And what's exciting about what's going on is the under $1 million market's actually quite healthy. One in two homes, 50% of the homes almost, are selling in this market. In green, we're seeing some positive trends. Let's stick with the under million. So 33 plus 25 that are sold already in the second half, plus 17 that are conditionally sold at the end of the month are 75 sales. So when we look at the 1 to 1.5 market, it's 8 plus 19, 9 here plus 10 conditional is 27. That market's actually come around quite nicely in the second half of the month, and we're up, you know, 120% in sales between the first half of the month and the second half of the month. In the under $1 million market, we're up about 27% from the first part. And then the top end of the market is actually struggling right now, but we've seen this before. We saw it with the financial crisis in 2008. In 2008, we had power plant issues in Oakville where the luxury home market stopped. Greek financial crisis in 2012 made the market stop. We've seen a lot of different things where we've seen a pause in the market, particularly in the affluent and the luxury home market, and that's what we're seeing today. So we'll over the course of the next few months, we'll see how this all shakes out. But we're seeing some with no relaxed viewings in terms of stay at home orders. We're actually seeing an increase in volume, which is pretty good. The other thing I wanted to quickly share with you is the showing trend and why we're seeing these numbers increase. Back in the better part of February and into mid-March, we were seeing 10,000 showings a month across the GTA. This is a Broker Bay chart. We get this from, they provide the front end and the software that runs our showings and appointment systems in 50% of the brokers in the GTA. So this is a good leading indicator. So you can see that we were up in this 10,000 showing zone up here, and the coronavirus pandemic start and stay-at-home orders brought us down into this 1,200 kind of category of showings daily in the first part of April, and it's done nothing but go up in April. And we're at this, on April 3rd, we're at 2,600. So you're having probably have a hard time seeing the scale, but it's from 800 to 2,800. So this trend is very, very helpful. It's a leading indicator. Showings happen, offers happen, sales happen afterwards in that kind of sequence. So this is positive, and it's supporting some of the things that we expect to see in May, with more showings as the market gets open, as the weather gets better, and as some optimism happens in our market. So anyways, my next videos will be contrasting some of the GTA West markets, including Milton, Mississauga, Burlington, and parts of Hamilton, and how they relate to the Oakville market. And we'll contrast them, and I'll show you some of that information, how each market is faring. As always, if there's any questions, anything specific you'd like to speak to me about, please call anytime. I'd be happy to talk to you about your specific real estate needs. Thank you.